ॐ सहनाववतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरि ओम। भगवद्गीता 17th चैप्टर 12th वर्स। अभिसन्दाय तु फलं दम्भार्थमपि चैवयत् इज्यते भरतश्रेष्ठ तं यज्ञं विद्धि राजसं। फलं फ्रूट, अभिसन्दाय सीकिंग तु, बट दम्भार्थं फॉर शो ऑफ, अपि आल्सो एव इंडीड च एंड यत विच इज्यते इज परफॉर्म्ड भरतश्रेष्ठ ओ द बेस्ट अमॉन्ग द भरतास और द पीपल हु बिलोंग टू द डायनेस्टी ऑफ किंग भरता भारतास तम दैट यज्ञम वैदिक सैक्रिफाइस राजसम राजसिका विद्धि नो। सो हियर श्री कृष्णा इज क्लासिफाइंग डिफरेंट वैदिक सैक्रिफाइसेस अकॉर्डिंग टू द थ्री गुनास और द गुनास ऑफ द पीपल हु डू इट। सो दैट यज्ञ विच इज परफॉर्म्ड फॉर फ्रूट एंड फॉर शोइंग ऑफ नो इट टू बी अ राजसिक यज्ञ नो इट टू बी अ राजसिक यज्ञ एंड देन विधिहीनम असृष्टान्नम मंत्रहीनम अदक्षिणम श्रद्धा विरहितम यज्ञम तामसम परिचक्षते। विधिहीनम without keeping to the Vedas, without following the Vedic instructions, asrishtannam, in which no food is distributed, mantrahinam, where no mantras are chanted, adakshinam, where no alms or gifts or charity is given, shraddha virahitam, which does not have shraddha or which does not have faith, yajnam, yajna, वैदिक सैक्रिफाइस तामसम तामसिका परिचक्षते इज टोल्ड टू बी और सेड टू बी। सो द यज्ञ विच इज नॉट विच इज परफॉर्म्ड नॉट अकॉर्डिंग टू द वैदिक इंस्ट्रक्शंस इन विच नो फूड इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड। सो इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग दैट व्हेन अ यज्ञ इज डन देर इज सम फूड विच इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड ऑफर्ड टू द गॉड ऑफर्ड टू द पीपल हु आर डूइंग द यज्ञ ऑफर्ड टू पीपल हु आर पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन द यज्ञ एटसेट्रा। Mantrahinam. So this is the tradition of Sanatana Dharma. This is the tradition of Bharata, that every ritual has food, has mantras, has gifts. So even if it is a very common function, food should be there, mantra should be there, and there should be some gift which is given. And Shraddha, faith in the scriptures, faith in the teacher. Yajnam tamasam parichakshate, that is said to be tamasa, tamasika, where no food is given, no mantras are told, and no dakshina is given. That means no gift or charity is given, and there is no faith. That is known to be tamasika yajnam. Then again, Sri Krishna divides tapas into three parts. Deva, three kinds, that is Sattvika, Rajasika and Tamasika. Deva Dvija Guru Prajna Pujanam Shaucham Arjavam Brahmacharyam Ahinsacha Shariram Tapa Uchyate. So here, first he divides into three kinds of tapa, that is physical tapa or austerity, then austerity of the speech, then austerity of the mind. And then he talks about how these austerities are done by Sattvika people or Rajasika people and Tamasika people. So Deva Dvija Guru Prajna Pujanam. Pujanam, worship of the Devas, the gods. The Dvija, Dvija means, Dvi means two, Ja means one who is born. So Dvija means twice born. Twice born, teeth is twice born. Teeth, first all teeth come and then the milk teeth goes away, then again teeth comes up. So teeth is twice born. Then all the andaja, all the creatures who who are born out of an egg are twice born. First the egg comes and then the egg is hatched, so twice born. Then all that comes out of seed, like plants or trees, they are also twice born, because first the seed is born and then from the seed the sprout comes, the sapling comes, so twice born. Then there are people who are given the sacred thread. So Brahmana, Kshatriya and Vaishya, they are given the sacred thread. So they are born first when their physical body is born, and they are again born when the sacred thread is invested. Investiture ceremony, it is called Yajna Upavita, Yajna Upavita. So a person becomes qualified to do Yajna, Yajna Upavita. So that is Upanayana, it's also called Upanayana. So one gets a separate eyes to look at the scriptures. So that is the second birth of that person. So twice born. So here twice born is Brahmanas, the Brahmins. Brahmanas who are generally priests and who come and do the priest work, who conduct the worship. So worship of the gods, worship of the priests or Brahmanas, and worship of the gurus and the wise. Prajna. Prajna means those who are wise. A wise person might, once one who has known the true nature, one's own true nature, that person need not be a Deva, need not be a Brahmana, need not be a guru, might have known one's true nature. And Saucham, purity. Arjavam, straightforwardness. Brahmacharyam is continence or celibacy, but these words are not faithful translations of the word Brahmacharyam, because Brahmacharya means it's much more vast a concept than just continence or celibacy. Ahimsa, non-injury, and Shacha and Shariram of the body, Tapaha, austerity, Uchyate is called. So worshipping the gods, worshipping the twice born, worshipping the gurus, worshipping wise, and having purity, straightforwardness, continence and non-injury are called the austerity of the body. Purity means what? Purity means the external and internal purity of a person, not thinking oneself to be the body and the mind, to think that one has got, to know that one has got a divine reality, divine existence, which is higher than the body and the mind, that is purity. Then what else is there? As first it is body, the tapasya or austerity of the body. Then comes the tapasya or austerity of the speech. Anudvega karam vakyam satyam priyahitam chayat swadhyaya bhyasanam chaiva vangmayam tapa uchyate. Anudvega karam, udvega karam, causing disturbance. Anudvega karam, not causing disturbance or not causing any kind of vexation or any kind of tension. Satyam, true. Priya hitam, priya, agreeable, and hitam, beneficial. Cha, also. Yat, which vakyam, speech. Swadhyaya abhyasanam, regular study of the Vedas. Cha eva, and also. Vangmayam, of speech. Tapaha, the austerity. Uchyate, is said. So, Vangmayam austerity, austerity of speech is what, which does not cause any kind of vexation, which is truth, and which is also speech, which is true, which is also Priyahitam, which is agreeable and beneficial. So here, one should understand, it's very important to speak the truth, but the truth should be presented in a manner which is not hurting the other person. It should be agreeable. And truth should be presented in a manner that makes the other person understand the beneficial part of the truth. But for no reason, just because it will be agreeable, it will be pleasant to hear, or it should be beneficial, for no reason should untruth be spoken. No reason should untruth be spoken. That is the idea here. So, Swadhyaya Abhyasanam, one has to study regularly the Vedas. One has to study the Veda so as to know what is the truth and what is told in the Vedas, or what has been instructed, that were to know that one has to study the Vedas. So, but for speech, austerity of speech, all these qualities should be there. Only then it will be austerity of speech. If one or some other quality is not there, then it will no more be austerity of speech. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Hari Om Tat Sat Shri Ramakrishna Arpanamastu.